I realized I've never shown you guys how to make pho on a stovetop only instant pot. I'm such a fake Vietnamese. Get yourself a big pot and fill it with beef bones. I'm making a lot because I have my whole entire family from California over here. Siblings, their wives, kids, girlfriends. We have a full house. Beef shank. Beef brisket. This is beef ribs from Costco. Add that in there as well. This is what my pot is looking like. It's filled to the brim almost. I'm filling this up with water. This is a 20 quart pot. All my beef bones, beef brisket, beef shank is at the bottom. I'm gonna turn my heat on and we're gonna parboil this, blanch this to get rid of all the scum. While we wait for our pot of beef to come to a boil, we're gonna prepare the rest of our aromatics. You need 2 large onions and 2 large pieces of ginger sliced in half. This is about a little bit smaller than the size of my hand. My hand is this big. We need to char this either on an open fire, air fryer, or a broiler. This is an onion my mom threw in here. Ignore that. As soon as you start to see some movement in the water, you're gonna leave this cook for 5 to 10 minutes. This is what it looks like after 10 minutes. Now we're gonna rinse and drain this under cold water. I'm gonna have my brother pour this because it's heavy. There's bones in there. Be careful, it might splatter. What the fuck? Dude, look at that
bullshit. Hey, this is heavy.
Are you getting a beef facial? Oh, shit.
That's good enough, thanks. Right?
Rinse your beef under cold water. Make sure you scrub using your thumb and be careful because there might be some sharp bone fragments. It's gonna look something like this when you're done. This is the pho spice bag that you need. It's the old man brand and I'm using the 1.5 ounce one. My mom and dad doesn't like the pho to be super overpowered and starchy, so we're using a smaller bag. If you want it to be more aromatic, has more of that smell, then use a bigger bag or use 2 of these. I'm gonna toast it on a dry skillet. I had this toasting for about 3 to 5 minutes. It's starting to crackle and there's smoke coming, so we can turn off our heat. Scaled. Add everything into the spice bag that it comes with. And there's our little spice bag. Should I tie this? Eh, I'm already committed to, so why not? Now that we have everything prepped, we're gonna add all of our ingredients into a clean stock pot. I'm gonna start off with the bones. Dump this in here. Beef shank, beef brisket, beef ribs. I like to add it towards the top because it's one of the first things I'm gonna take out. Our charred, it's black, it's okay. Our charred onions, ginger. This is rock sugar. I'm gonna add about 3 golf ball sizes and some salt. We're gonna fill this pot up with water. Turn the heat on and bring this to a boil. You see how there's some movement? If this thing wasn't so packed with beef bones and beef, it would be boiling, but because it's so packed, it's hard to tell. When it looks something like this, you're gonna reduce your heat and simmer for at least 7 hours uncovered. During the simmering process, there's gonna be a lot of foam that floats to the top. Make sure you scoop this all out. Justin, I need your help. Can you help me grab this beef shank out and put it into this ice bath?
Yeah.
My brother's gonna help because I'm holding at the meat. So you're gonna take the beef shank out and put it into an ice bath. You got it? Wow, you are pretty useful sometimes.
I try.
You also need to take out the beef brisket and place it into an ice bath.
I forgot to film this, but you also need to remove your beef ribs and place them into an ice bath.
The ice bath will help it from discoloring.
So, ladies.
I've had this simmering for a total of 2 hours. I have now removed my beef shank, my beef brisket, and my beef ribs.
See how this is where the water line was originally? I'm gonna fill it back up to that line. This is what it looks like after the beef bones, beef brisket, and beef ribs are out. We're gonna leave this to continue simmering some more.
When there's 30 to 60 minutes left remaining in your simmering process, you're gonna add your spice bag. That's Joanne, my sister-in-law. Soon to be sister-in-law, hopefully.
Yeah, she better act right.
When are you gonna propose to her?
After 30 to 60 minutes, take your spice bag out. I say 30 to 60 minutes because you want to base it off what your pot of pho smells like. If it smells good enough for you, then take it out at 30 minutes. If you want it to smell a little bit more, then take it out at 60 minutes. But this has been simmering for 8 hours. I'm going to turn off my heat now.
I'm gonna remove everything and discard it, starting with our onion, ginger slices, and our beef bones. You're gonna pour your broth through a fine strainer. I'm having my husband help me because it's heavy. Thanks, baby.
I had this sitting overnight so the fat can harden.
There's a lot of other methods you can do to remove the fat, but I prefer this method because it's just the easiest for a large quantity of broth like this. I'm gonna reserve this because this is the nuke mayo, the fat water that restaurants normally charge you extra for. And I'll have to show you guys how to use this with your broth later on. You're gonna taste your broth to see if it needs any adjustments. Normally, I always adjust it. I season with some fish sauce, chicken bouillon. I just burnt my throat. Now, Ben.
At home with a pair?